The deputy head of unit, Israel Ocho, says most of the land fraud cases are perpetrated by politicians and technocrats in Lira District and Lira City. He says that the unit started investigating the land cases in Lira City and District way back in 2022. Ocho explained the cases that have so far been charged in court across the country since December 2018 and recovered 51 billion shillings.
Nguwahi documents, melobo, dili yuta hameri yang wajkirkana peungneo, dekarayo. Anti-corruption unit that is in State House has done a commendable job in the recent past in bringing sanity in service delivery and civil service by fighting corruption at every level. I know I have been working with you for close to 3 years now in trying to weed out corruption from amongst our people and also to draw back the confidence of the people on the government, because the people think the government is corrupt, but there are individuals that are corrupt, and it is these individuals that you are trying to weed out. I want to call upon the leaders in this country.
He observes that despite directives from the Attorney General and the Minister of Local Government and that of Lands, Lira District continue to carry out irregular transactions inland within the jurisdiction of the city. On claims that some of the land was sold as a resolution of council, Ochoa says council cannot pass an illegal resolution and they just sit back and allow it to stand.
The deputy head corruption unit, at times we have leaders who encourage corruption by supporting the corrupt and their activities. And if this is not dealt with, it is threatening the very moral fabrics of this nation. And every leader must know condoning corruption is corruption in itself. Several letters have been written from this region, but I am happy that the community of Lamu are engaged in the fight against corruption. And I thank you, the journalists, the media houses in Lamu, for your role in the fight against corruption.
The resident city commissioner, Lawrence Igole, says the anti-corruption unit has done a tremendous job in the recent past in bringing sanity in service delivery in civil service by fighting corruption.
In late 2018, I think in early 2019, Lamu, I think, was the fourth, Lamu sub-region was the fourth place we visited. And I want to appreciate the people of Lamu from that time until now, the boldness you have shown in fighting corruption. It is only when we visited among the very many regions we went to, it is only in Lamu where we saw ordinary citizens standing up in the open when we had our public barrazas and telling their leaders that no, what you're saying is not the truth. This is the truth that we have witnessed as citizens.
According to reports by the anti-corruption unit, some politicians and technocrats are facilitating land grabbing. They fraudulently register the land acquired illegally in the names of their relatives and sell it to businessmen. Story compiled by Hudson Apunyu for the news.